Hello. Let's get started setting up your LaserCube.
Warning, lasers are dangerous.
Make sure to completely read and understand all safety guidelines before operating your laser. Installing the LaserCube. Make sure the laser does not project onto people or other animals. Make sure the beam blocker is closed when handling the LaserCube for charging, installing, or transporting. The internal battery should be charged before use. The charging status LED will be red if the battery is charging and green if it's fully charged. Install the laser at a height of 3 meters or 10 feet above anywhere people may be present. To fasten your LaserCube, use the tripod mount located on the bottom of the LaserCube and any adapters needed to attach it firmly to your support structure. An eye bolt is provided for additional support to prevent damage or injury from dropping your LaserCube. Once the LaserCube is securely installed, connect the antenna, safety jumper, and key. No cables are required to operate the LaserCube, but if you wish to keep the power cable in during use or are using a wired LAN connection, make sure all cables are fastened securely. Turn on the power switch and turn the key until the two white lights turn on. It is now ready for operation. Network connection. There are several ways of connecting your control device, iPhone, Android, Windows PC, or Mac to your LaserCube. By default, the LaserCube is in Wi-Fi server mode. In Wi-Fi server mode, the LaserCube acts as a 2.4 GHz wireless network named LaserCube with a password Laser2020, which is case sensitive. Connect to the LaserCube network with the settings on your control device. The connection status LED next to the antenna will flash while waiting for a connection or will remain constantly lit when connected. To switch connection modes, press and hold the mode button until the LaserCube projects the connection mode. An asterisk will be displayed next to the mode the LaserCube is currently set to. To switch modes, single press the mode button until the desired mode is displayed, then hold down the mode button until the LaserCube restarts. In Wi-Fi client mode, press and hold the mode button until the status LED turns white. It is now ready to connect to your WPS network router. Press the WPS button on your router. When connected successfully, the status LED on the LaserCube will turn solid blue. Many connection modes will be covered in a separate video. Installing Laser OS. Install Laser OS on your device from the App Store, the Play Store, or laseros.com. Once installed, start Laser OS and it should detect any LaserCubes on the network you're connected to. On a smartphone, if the play arrow is blue, it means you're connected to the LaserCube. If it's grayed out, check your connection and try again. On a Mac or Windows PC, Laser OS will display Laser Off in the upper left side above the preview panel when connected correctly. If not, it will display No Laser. When you're ready to project a laser show, switch to Laser On or tap the play button on a smartphone. If the LaserCube is projecting into areas you wish to protect, you can use the beam blocker to cut off the lower projections. You can also set safety zones within the projection area from the settings menu. This is also covered in a separate video linked below. Thank you for safely using the LaserCube. Enjoy the show!